Gyvenimas taip jau sudėliotas, kad kiekvienam žmogui pamatus dažniausiai sudeda šeima. Jimui ir Cindy Barnų šeimoje gimus sūnui abejonių nebuvo. Šis obuolys nuo obels toli tikrai nenuriedės. Vos pernai trenerio karjerą baigęs, Brooklyn'e 8 vaikų šeimoje užaugęs Barnas vyresnysis, jau pačioje pokalbio pradžioje netikėtai išsiduoda, kad Lietuvą pirmą kartą aplankė daugiau nei prieš 20 metų.
You know, Lithuania was a great country of looking at potential high school players wanting to come to the United States. And I was involved with the player Rimas Kaukainis, and who went to high school in New York State. And so I kind of followed him. And then also I went to Salutu Stepas, who had a camp himself.
Rimas actually came to our house in Rhode Island on a recruiting visit. And I was probably 12 or 13 years old at the time, but I remember we were outside in the driveway playing basketball, little one-on-one shooting contest. And now him and I stay pretty close and we talk with each other still to this day. And you know, I've played against him, you know, when I was in Rome and he was in Reggio. So we've, you know, it's been kind of cool to see how it comes full circle, you know, from all the way back then till right now.
It's unbelievable. It's like a dream come true to come back to Lithuania after all these years to see him. And it's, you know, it's great. It's great because, you know, it's a great country. The city is a beautiful city. And, you know, it's got a really, really good tradition of quality basketball.
Sužinojus apie tokius tamprius Barnų šeimos ryšius su mūsų šalimi, faktas, kad abu buvusio Panamos nacionalinės rinktinės trenerio sūnus yra rungtyniavę Lietuvoje, atrodo labiau likimo pirštas nei paprastas atsitiktinumas.
Jimmy was a great mentor for Billy. You know, Billy kind of was very, very proud of Jimmy's accomplishments, and me as a dad was tremendously proud to see him go to high school, to prep school, and then I was able to be fortunate enough to coach him at the University of Rhode Island. So I think he was a very good leader, not only on the basketball court, but for his younger brother.
And he's always been, you know, a great player, someone who's always wanted to learn. And I have the benefit of being an older brother and being able to have someone look up to me. So as an older brother, you have that responsibility. You want to try and do the best you can, you know, for him.
It's a beautiful feeling to see them on the court and to see them develop as players and as young men. It's a fabulous experience for a dad because when I grew up, I had eight kids in my family. And we had 7 boys. So my father really ever seen me play, maybe on television once in a while. So to have this opportunity is phenomenal.
When I watch him on film of when he was a player, it gives me an opportunity to be a coach and critique how he played as a player. So it all comes full circle.
Beveik 40 metų įvairias NCAA komandas treniravusio stratego auklėtiniais yra buvę ir abu jo sūnus.
Yeah, the first 2 years were very tough. You know, I kind of had to gain trust from the other teammates. You know, maybe had to do some things wrong that I would get in trouble from by the coach just to prove that they could trust me.
He had great leadership skills to lead the team, and I really never had a problem with him. The reason being is because he was the hardest worker and he had the highest level of achievement. He wanted to be a great player.
I think what the one thing my father did great that he might not know is he really like allowed myself to like develop a love for the game. So, you know, as a player, you're not gonna work as hard as you can if you don't love what you're doing. So he didn't really start challenging me until I asked him to. I remember like it was yesterday, I had a really bad game. I was embarrassed, there was a lot of people watching. I remember I was crying after the game. And I told him, I said, Dad, I need you to push me and coach me because I don't want to have this feeling again. So I remember he was at St. Bonaventure at the time in New York, and we went to their gymnasium and turned on the lights, and we stayed and worked until maybe 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. My mother wasn't too happy about that, but you know, from that point forward is when he really started to become my coach also, and not just my father.
Abu vyrai pripažįsta, kad didelį darbą palaikant darną šeimoje atliko mama. Jungtinėse Amerikos valstijose pripažintai menininkiai nebuvo lengva laviruoti tarp žmonos ir motinos vaidmens. Bet puikiais diplomatijos gebėjimais pasižyminti moteris jautė, kuriuos mygtukus ir kada reikia paspausti.
She had the hardest job out of anyone, because she had to deal with both of us, especially after a hard practice, or say we're getting together as a family and having dinner or going to church, you know. Say if it's after a bad game or a bad practice or something like this, it's, you know, it's tough because you have to turn it off, you know, and then be a family. And then when you go back to work and to practice, you have to turn it back on again and go back to your job.
One of the ground rules, and I've always told him, I said, listen, on the court, I'm your coach. Off the court, I'm your dad.
It's easier said than done.
So, you know, but it's tough. Because I remember, you know, his first year, you know, he would say, Dad, 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 and I say, Jimmy, I'm your coach right here. It's very emotional. It's very emotional. It's a roller coaster. And that's why, you know, his mother was just so much of a buffer between him and I to just make sure we separated.
Džimas atskleidė, kad trenerio karjerą nusprendė baigti norėdamas daugiau laiko praleisti su savo artimaisiais, kuriuos išsibarščiusius po visą pasaulį surinkti prie bendro šventinio stalo šiuo metu yra labai sudėtinga.
Tradition was always try to come together as a family and you know, really enjoy each other, you know, on a great occasion and share presents and gifts, but the greatest gift is his happiness and his success in life and his health and the family. And that's the most beautiful thing for me as a father.